In this video, I'm going to tell you how you can easily scale your small size business, medium size business, or large size business within a year or in 6 months up to $1 million business. Yes, you heard it right. I had a private consultation with a person who scaled their business within 6 months. With 6 months to 12 months up to $1 million company yearly. If you implement these techniques, I can't share that whole video to you because that's was private consultancy, but I squeezed the whole conversation within 13 simple steps. If you implement these 13 simple steps in your business, you can scale it to $1 million company. So I am Prash Agarwal, business coach, entrepreneur, influencer marketing specialist. So let's start the video. 13 tips to grow your small size, medium size, or large size business within $1 million company within 6 months to 1 year if you implement this technique. First one is you have to start working on social media platforms. Yes, they tell me that you can scale your business up to a tons of money, but if you are not able to grab the attention of all the audience out there, maybe you are able to grab the attention of 100 people. Instead of that, if you are using social media platform, you can grab the attention of thousands, lakhs, even crores of people. So what you have to do, you just have to build out your profiles on social media platform. It can help you to grab more attention, and you must implement some strategies to convert that attention into leads and in leads to customers. Okay, after that, what you have to use, you have to utilize your revenue, utilize your profit on ads. Let's suppose you are using Google ads and FB ads. They are the best in current time. If you are using those ads to generate more leads for your business, what you have to do? You just have to strategize them. If they are helping you to generate net profit easily, then go ahead. If these ads are not working, if these ads are not able to generate the profit, the amount you think in your mind, then you have to work on your strategies. Redesign the ad. Obviously, just redesign the ad, implement it, and see if this ad gives me result. If not, change it. Okay, be consistent over your efforts and understand which thing works, which thing grabs the attention of the audience. If you don't check out that video, I have already uploaded many videos in business strategies regarding that thing. You can check out. Video will be powered in the ID section playlist. Apart from this, when you are using ads, Google ads, FB ads, you can generate tons of leads. What you have to do, you just have to convert those leads into customers. Okay, first of all, you have to do a one-to-one conversation, or you can hire a marketing team for that, because you are the CEO of the business, so you have a lot of work. You have to manage your team, you have to do a lot of things. So how you can do one-to-one conversation? In the beginning, you have a small size business, you can do by yourself, but business is taking leverage of other people's skill to build out your business and make tons of money by providing tons of value. So leverage the other people's skill, hire a marketing team for that. They do a one-to-one conversation with those persons, or what type of sales funnels you are using to convert those leads into customers. After that, you have to understand that the profit I am making, is this the profit I thought in my mind before running the ads? If not, change the ad, redesign the ad, and invest some money on ads. Your ads are working, it's making profit, that's good. If not, you just have to redesign that. And if they are making profit, and all the profit gets in the team or the employees working, and you are not able to get any money for yourself or for your business, or to reinvest in those ads or in strategies, then you are making some mistakes. You just have to again redesign that. You have to work on your marketing strategies. Apart from this, what you have to do, you have to reinvest at least 20% of your revenue to the ads, because they are the things which getting the most of the attention from the customers all over the world. So what you have to do, you have to invest at least 20% of your revenue with ads. Okay, second point, never be at mercy of something else. Yes, build out your business on your terms. Learn it, implement it, and understand which thing works, which doesn't. Okay, after understanding this thing, implement the things which gives you more and more results for your business or for you. Don't take someone's opinions, or don't take someone's help to build your business, because after that, these people will say that I helped that person to build out their business and he doesn't know about that business. It stings you more. So just work on your skills, grow your business from scratch, from yourself. Understand the things, learn from books, learn from videos on personal mentorship, and a lot of things you can get from internet or one-to-one coaching. Just build out your business by your learnings, implementation, and getting results. Understand this phase. When you are growing your business, what you have to do? You just have to solve out the pain problems of the customers, of your target customers. Not all the customers in the world. You just have to find out your target audience. You have to understand what is the pain points they are going through, and by your product or service, you just have to solve out their problem by just getting attention and tell them, I can solve your problem in this phase by my product or by service easily. So you can get rid from this problem completely. Third important lesson I squeezed up from the overall conversation is that you just have to use 20% revenue or 20% efforts to build out something else apart from your business, apart from your company. So if this 80% goes away, with these 20% you can survive and build out another business, build out same business again. So what you have to do, you can build out your personal brand, or you can do branding for your business, and a lot of stuff you can try. Just take out 20% of everything to build out something. If your 80% goes away, then you can stand alone by using that 20%, and you can scale these 20% up to 100% within few years, because now you are not working from scratch. You have learnings, you know which thing works, which doesn't. So you just have to reapply those techniques. You just have to configure that I applied these things. This works, this doesn't. So I have to go from this. Okay, you just have to go with this and reapply these techniques to get more results for your business. So easy, right? But always build out something else apart from your business, so it can sustain your life. It can sustain life of your employees or your business. Because apart from providing value, what does a role of business? It's all about taking the leverage of other people's skills to make tons of money, to make a beautiful lifestyle for you. Okay, so understand this thing. If your business goes away, how you can sustain in your life? How you can maintain your lifestyle? Okay, so build out something else which can help you to build out same business or another business when your main business goes away from the market. Okay, apart from this, the fourth important lesson I learned from this conversation is that how much less you can pay to yourself in the starting when you are able to convert only 30% of the leads, and boom, everything goes away. Yes, when you are able to convert 30% of your leads, what are the leads you are generating from social media platform, from targeting ads, whatever the marketing medium you are using, by using blogs, vlogs, there are lots of stuff. So what are the leads you are generating, and you are able to convert only 30% of those leads into customer? 30% is a lot of leads. 30%, if you are able to convert 30% of leads into customers, this is a very good average. Okay, apart from this, you just have to squeeze all the 30%. Yes, how much less you can pay yourself when you are converting these 30% leads into customers when you are growing your business? Because in the beginning, what people do, they start paying themselves. It's good. When you are doing business, you just have to pay yourself first. But if you are paying too much to yourself, then you are not able to scale up your business. If you want to scale up your business, what you have to do? You just have to pay at least amount, so the rest amount you can reinvest in your business, or to grow any department, or to hire any marketing team, or to hire some employees to leverage some more skills, some more tasks to do. Okay, understand this is, business is all about taking leverage of other people's skills. Okay, so pay less to yourself and use rest of the money to grow your business, to scale up your business. Fifth important lesson, that many people do same mistake in the business. Yes, many people want to do business, and when they start building out business from scratch, they do the same mistake. What they do? They don't able to squeeze up in the beginning and regret later that I have that much leads, I have that much attention, why I'm not able to convert those leads? If you think that I'm generating some, let's suppose 100 leads, and I'm only able to convert 1-2% leads, that's too low. That's too low. You just have to figure out the right strategies to convert your leads into customers. Maybe you are not able to do a fruitful conversation with your customers. Maybe your product or service is not good. Maybe you are not confident in the conversation. Maybe you are not able to give them a path how your product or service can solve their problems. So understand this phase. When you are in the beginning or you are in the middle of the phase or you are generating tells something, you just have to squeeze all the leads into customers so you can generate a lot of profit, because at the end you just have to reinvest that money. At the end you have to pay amount to your employees. At the end you have to buy something to leverage more people's skills for your business. So understand thing, the more money you will get, the more money you will reinvest, and the more money you will generate. It's like a code. You just have to implement that thing. You don't have to regret later. Just squeeze as much your leads to convert them into customers. Give them proper path how you can solve out their problems. Give them proper knowledge how your product or service gonna help them to rid out from this problem. How they can feel better. How they can transform their life by using your product or services. Okay. Sixth tip is when you're doing business, obviously you are confident on the idea, whatever the idea you come up for your business. So understand this first. If you think I have proper strategies to grow my business, I am too much confident that my idea definitely works, I have target audience, I have target market, I have proper strategies how to convert those leads into proper customers. So maybe in the starting you have money issues. Obviously there are lots of people who don't have enough money to invest in the business or to start any business. That's why they are not able to start their business. That's an excuse, but let's suppose really you don't have money. What you can do, you are confident to your idea, you have proper strategies how your idea can frame a fruitful business, a business which can generate tons of money. What you have to do, you can take loan from any person, or you can borrow some amount of money from the person, like money lenders with some interest, and you know that I can grow my scale with this time frame. Within this time frame, I can grow my business up to that level, and I can return all the profit, all the interest to the money lenders. What you have to do? You have to go through. You have to take a step. You have to build out your business. You have to scale it massively and return all the money what you borrowed from money lenders. You have to take a risk. When you are doing business, you are taking the risk. So believe in yourself. Be confident on your ideas and make proper strategies how you can scale it up. Because at the end, the thing matters, do you have right strategies or not? Because the main thing people fail in the business, they try to do everything on their own. That's the wrong thing they are trying to do. What you have to do, you just have to take the leverage of other people's skills. You have to hire the people, you have to hire the correct set of people for your business, and they will help you to grow your business. What you have to do, you just have to manage them properly. You just able to get out to work from them to scale your business or to build up your business. You can borrow some money from money lenders for your business too. Okay, apart from this, the seventh technique, the seventh tip is the most crucial tip. Do you know why entrepreneurs win in every phase? Do you know why? Because in the starting, they face a lot of failures and they face a lot of no. Yeah, they will meet up to the persons when they show their plan or whatever the product or service they want to grow, whatever the idea they came up for. If they show this to another person, they will soon say no, because at the starting you don't have any skill set. When you are starting your journey, three main skills you just have to work on. First one is communication skills. Second one is leadership skills. Third one is management skills. You just have to start working on those three skills. Apart from this, you can scale any business if you have these three skills in your life. So work on those skills. And the main thing, why entrepreneurs win? They already face a lot of problems and they get addicted to that people say, no, I have to work on my skill set. They get too much optimistic in their path. That's the only reason why they win in every phase. Because in the starting, they work on their work ethics, how they can increase their work ethics, how to be consistent over their efforts, and how to generate tons of money by getting right skill set. What people think, I can generate that much money, but I don't have that much skill set. How you can grow, man? You just have to enhance your skill set. Money is a byproduct of that thing. When you are doing a private consultation, I ask them, when you are at a small level or medium level and you don't have enough money to hire marketing teams or hire any employees for your business, how you can start your business, how you can initialize, or how you can take an asset. They say, First of all, that's an excuse. I said, that's not an excuse. Let's suppose there's a genuine person who really wants to start a business, but that's a problem. They are not able to hire some employees, because at the end, what is business about? Business is all about taking advantage of other people's skills. So they said to me, in every phase, in each day, in every week, or in every month, there are lots of people who are working on their skills, but they are beginner. But they are beginner and people are not paying for them. What you can do, you can hire them to say that I can't pay you that much amount, but I will give you badges, I will give you a certification that you worked in our company and you helped us to reach that level or to scale up this thing or to work out in this thing. What they get certifications, they are building their portfolios by your company, and you are also get your work complete. It's a win-win situation. It's a win-win situation. Understand that thing? You are not paying any money to them, but your work is getting done. You are hiring employees. So when you get your work done, you are able to generate profit. Give them their salary. If you are able to give them their salary, you can hire those employees, because they work in your company. In the starting, they know how you can scale up more. They know everything about your company. So it's better to work on those employees which already know everything about your company, rather than hiring new employees again and again and again and again. Hiring is the main thing, because you need to find the right people for your business. But if you already found in the beginning, why have to hire again? So stick them to your company by paying salary. Okay. Ninth tip is, many people have their skills in consulting with other businesses because they know their proper strategies, how they can work on and enhance or to scale up their business. So you can provide consultation service, that's true, but there is a problem. You are doing consultation of, let's suppose, a business. Okay, your strategies work for that business and they are scaling up every year up to a next level. What you get? You just get a small amount. You get your consultation fees, but what this business is getting? Profit, increasing profit every year, right? Understand that thing. So you have proper strategies to work on. Why are you not starting your own business? You can start your own business consulting field also. Yes, you can hire some employees, you can consult them, you can help them to enhance their skill set. So you can set up a company, set up a business where you can consult other people's business. So that's how you get cash flow in your business. You are having right skill set, you have proper techniques to work on in the business, but you are not able to work on those things for you. How this thing can help you? So understand that thing, you can open up your own consultation business and it will help you to generate cash flow. And after that, if you are able to automate that business, nothing is blissful than automated business. You can get tons of money every year, every month to you without doing any work. By just putting 5 to 15 years work, after that you can automate that business, because you know what are the problems in the market, what are the problems business are facing, and if you are able to automate them, you get cash flow throughout the life without working. After working only 15-20 years, you get cash flow throughout your life. 10th tip is, building culture and community for your business is too important. Yes, this helped me. I started my company around 9 years ago. In the starting, I did a meeting with my every team. I attend those meetings, I give my ideas, I give proper follow-ups, I understand their concept, how their concept can scale up my business. And now, after 9 years, I'm not attending any meeting. I said, why? Why you are not attending any meeting? If the strategies are not working, what? They said, I know them. They are working since beginning in my business, so I am monitoring them, but I am not attending their meeting because I know their skill set. I build a community for that. Their team is their community. After that, I prepared a culture. These communities are following a culture in my business, so it doesn't matter whether I am attending the meeting, whether not. They can do their work alone. They can do their work in a community and can scale up the business, because that's a culture I bring up to my business. So what you have to do, you just have to cultivate a culture in your business, in your teams, to get away from meetings, because at the end you have a lot of work, you have to manage a lot of people's hire, fire and a lot of stuff. So build up a culture for your business. 11th tip, I squeezed up from that conversation is be a consumer centric, because at the end you are solving all the problems of customers, target audience. So what you have to do, you have to figure out what are the pain points, you have to make your product or service according to that. But apart from this, they are not able to take a step. The thing is lacking. Your product can solve out their problems, they also have problems, but why your product is not selling, why their problem is not getting solved? Because there is a communication gap between you and them. Maybe they are not aware about your product or service, how this service or product can solve out their problem. What you have to do, you just have to hire employees for that. Which what they do a one-to-one conversation with those persons, so it make them relax, and it creates credibility that your product or service is gonna solve out their problem easily. 12th tip, I understand from this conversation that maybe you scale up your business within 5 years. That's great. So maybe you are scaling up your business up to a next level easily. But what happened after 5 years, 10 years, you get out from the market, your business gets failed totally. Why? This is the reason. And what's the reason? Market is changing every time. There are lots of things are going in the market. There are lots of persons who are working in the market. There are lots of competitors who are struggling to get ahead from each other. You have to understand this concept. You have to reshape your strategies. You have to reshape your business according to that. Because your product or service definitely solve out the problem. But what if you are not able to reach out those customers to target audience? Understand that is that market is going to be a very important aspect in this scenario. What you have to do, just have to reshape your strategies according to the market, because market is changing every time. And the 13th or last bonus tip for you is you have to give advice for first 150 people for free, of course. Yes, when you are start building out your business, a person brought on social media platforms, people will approach you if they like your content and if you are providing massive value throughout your content. If you are providing this, then people will definitely approach you. Give them a piece of advice to solve out their pain points. You don't have to push your product or customers at that phase to your customers or your target audience, whatever the person is approaching you for your advice. Just give them advice free of cost. After that, they will reapproach you if your advice is fruitful to them. Okay, and they will buy your product or service in this phase. You just have to pitch out your product or service in second phase, when they are reapproaching you to solve out their problems, when your advice is fruitful to them. And if you are working in this niche, then your advice will definitely help them to solve out their pain points. Just be an expert, communicate with like an expert, and that's how you can sell out your product or services and generate lots of money. I already uploaded many videos regarding this, and in this I am thinking that I don't have to share this video, because this video is too valuable. Because that was a private consultation with that company, with a person who generates $1 billion by his company working in this phase. But I'm providing value, so I have to share that thing. Apart from this, what you have to do, subscribe to my YouTube channel, tap on the bell icon so you can get my video first, because I'm uploading a lot of videos regarding strategies, business strategies, entrepreneurship journey, marketing journey, as well as I started to doing lives with the top 1% entrepreneurs. I already uploaded one video, you can check out that too. You just have to go through those videos if you are scaling your business, if you are starting your business or starting any entrepreneurship journey, or you are working in marketing. Start watching these videos, start consuming that content. It will give you a positive mind and it will give you a correct path to operate it. Okay, apart from this, in the starting I already said you have to give your 20% to build out something which can help you to generate 80% of your money when your 80% goes away. What you have to do, you have to do a personal brand. So 10 tips for personal branding. Watch out that video right now to build out a personal brand successfully. Watch out now.